Hello, everyone. My name is Dr. Carol Wada. I'm a physician, and I'm also a Sjogren's disease patient. And today I need to talk about something that is, in my opinion, one of the most dangerously overlooked aspects of chronic autoimmune care. It's something that for anyone with dry mouth, whether it's related to Sjogren's disease, medications, or anything else, is completely non-negotiable. Our healthcare system pretty stupidly separated the mouth from the rest of our body decades ago. And by creating this artificial divide between medical and dental, we have created a whole host of problems. I'm here to tell you that this separation is not just inconvenient, it is actively harming our health. Let's be crystal clear. Your mouth is not just for smiling and for eating and for social interaction. It is literally where your immune and nervous systems start their first security check on everything coming in from the outside world. It is the first place where digestion starts as well. It's the gateway. Think about it. Your saliva, it isn't just water. It is a complex fluid packed with enzymes that begin digestion and contain powerful antimicrobial proteins that are your first line of defense against bacteria and viruses. It's constantly washing away debris and neutralizing acids that would otherwise destroy our enamel and our teeth. When you have dry mouth, also known as xerostomia, that entire first line of defense collapses. Without adequate saliva, harmful bacteria are free to multiply. We call these sugar bugs in our house, courtesy of our pediatric dentist. And this doesn't just lead to cavities and gum disease. It creates a state of chronic inflammation right at the entrance to your body. Every time you swallow, you're sending that inflammatory signal down your digestive tract, potentially contributing to gut dysbiosis and a whole cascade of other health issues. Your mouth is where the defense and digestion processes begin. Investing in your oral health isn't about vanity. It's about fighting systemic inflammation and investing in your future self. Now, for those of us with Sjogren's, this isn't a minor issue. It's a central feature of our disease. The autoimmune attack on our salivary glands isn't just inconvenient. It's a direct assault on a critical part of our immune network. And the consequences are profound. We dramatically see an increased risk for aggressive dental decay, cavities that seem to pop up almost overnight, even with meticulous brushing and flossing, periodontal or gum disease, which itself is a major driver of systemic inflammation, and for many decades has been known to be linked to heart disease and other chronic conditions. Oral thrush or yeast infections, usually we think about in little babies, but can also occur in adults. And for me, if I see a patient with thrush and they don't already have a diagnosis of Sjogren's disease or some other condition related to dry mouth, I'm asking those questions. It is a sign that delicate balance of your oral microbiome has been disrupted. Difficulty swallowing and speaking. This impacts your nutrition and your social connection. You may even notice today, I'm recording this early in the morning, I haven't totally hydrated yet, and I'm having a little trouble of getting those words out. And it's not just because I haven't had my second cup of coffee. The last consequence that I see more frequently than I like with is burning mouth syndrome. This is a painful neurologic condition and complication that can frankly be totally debilitating, where your taste, any irritants or other substances coming into the mouth can trigger intense burning pain. Treating your mouth isn't just about comfort. It's about reducing the overall inflammatory burden on a body that is already working overtime. It's a non-negotiable part of managing Sjogren's effectively. So how do we do this? How do we rebel against a system that has ignored the mouth for so long and frankly makes it incredibly expensive to get care at times? First, we apply the 4R framework. We recognize the problem. We acknowledge that our oral health is health, period. We stop thinking of dental appointments as optional and start seeing them as essential parts of our autoimmune care. We face the fear. Second, we reclaim our power. This means getting educated. It means learning about the specific products that can help, things like xylitol-based mints and gels, specialized toothpastes, and pH balancing rinses. It's about understanding that simply drinking more water often isn't always enough. Third, we rebel with principle. We rebel against the idea that we just have to live with a dry, painful mouth. This is where we get proactive and into our momentum. And the scariest step for many of us is making the appointment. Find a dentist or dental hygienist who is knowledgeable about, or at least willing to learn about, Sjogren's disease. And it can be hard, but they are out there. Bring them your information. Advocate for yourself. The other part of being a rebel is pushing it back against some of the ingrained habits that we have built over time. For me, this was giving up at least a decade long history and like habit of having a Diet Coke with my lunch every day. And yes, I still do have an occasional sparkling water, which is probably still not perfect for my teeth. All my dental friends can weigh in. We got to live a little bit. It also has really changed how I think about snacking and trying to minimize snacking, which can increase the rate and the number of times that our teeth are being affected. And finally, we rise. We rise by creating these new habits. Consistent and meticulous oral hygiene isn't just about preventing cavities. It is an act of self-care. It's a daily commitment to reducing inflammation and supporting our entire system. I know this can feel overwhelming. I know that for many, the dentist is a place of fear, a place of shame and anxiety, especially when you feel like your body is already turning against you. And I felt that shame. I remember there was a time, very likely when my Sjogren's was getting going during medical school, that I didn't have dental insurance. And I was so fearful of that, making that initial appointment when I finally got coverage again. And frankly, I haven't thought about that story for a while, and just that profound sense of, oh. And the dentist I found, I'm still with, she's fantastic. Thanks, Dr. Sadanini, Dublin Metro Dental here in the Columbus area. But she really helped me come up with a plan, because unfortunately, I did a lot of damage during medical school to my teeth. In hindsight, I do wonder if subtle dry mouth really pushed things in that forward direction, but I lost a ton of enamel from grinding my teeth, not wearing my night guard, and had to have a lot of repair work done. And as a fresh medical school grad with six digits in educational debt and frankly not the highest paycheck as a resident, that was really an incredibly scary place and situation to be in. And I was thankful to be met by a care team that didn't meet me with judgment, but really treated me with loving kindness and care. I want you to hear me on this. We can do scary things. That phone call to a new dentist's office, that's a scary new thing that we can do. That conversation where you explain that Sjogren's is doing what it's doing to your mouth, that's something scary that you can practice and that you can do. And walking into that appointment, even with your heart pounding, you can do it. Because on the other side of that fear is empowerment. On the other side is relief. And on the other side is a healthier future self who will thank you for being brave today. Make the appointment. I want to share a quick little story, unrelated. I'm known for that. Yes, my patients or my husband and my kids. But I went horseback riding for the very first time at 41 just a couple of weeks ago. I went with my girls. I was part of a Girl Scout outing. And my almost 7-year-old was so nervous. She had tears going down her cheeks. She was safe. The team at the ranch was so lovely in helping hype her up, make her feel safer. And as she got accustomed to being on the horse, I saw the smile and the sense of pride. And when we finished our hour-long little walk, trail ride, she got off that horse and she was so proud of herself. And all I can think of is how it feels when we do these really scary things. And afterwards, after we recognize what we've done and how we've overcome that fear, it's pretty profound. I want to let the deep dive in the importance of oral health is just one piece of this massive Sjogren's puzzle. And over the last 4 years at the virtual Sjogren's Summit, we have brought together leading experts to tackle every aspect of this disease. I'm going to say almost every aspect because this disease like continues to surprise us, but we have a lot from experts across dentistry and oral health, neurology, nutrition and mental health, lifestyle, you name it. The live event for 2025 is just wrapping up, but we believe this knowledge is too important to disappear. And that's why we've created an incredible evergreen resource for your entire journey. I'm so excited to introduce the Sjogren's Summit 4-Year Library. It is $97, and for that, you get lifetime on-demand access to every single session from all 4 of our annual summit events. It's over 80 hours of expert presentations, including multiple deep dives on oral health from 2022 through 2025. It's an entire vault of knowledge to help you become the most empowered advocate for your own health. And as a special note for our 2025 All Access Pass supporters who already signed up, we are so grateful for you. Please check your email for a special thank you offer to complete your library for a very small additional investment. Your mouth is not separate from your body. Your health is a completely interconnected network. And by investing in one part, you lift the entire system, the whole. I want to thank you for being here today. Now go make that appointment. You've got this. Until next time, take care.